2 subscribers away from 7K. Let's go. Woo! Well, there are so many nice whips out today, bro. I'm so hyped.
Got a little snack in the rear view, a little V6 Challenger. Okay.
One more subscriber. Let's go. Let's freaking go, you guys. 7K on YouTube. Finally, we just crossed 7K. Oh my God, am I hyped. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the vlog and happy 4th of July. Today is Independence Day, 4th of July, and I want to say happy 4th of July to everybody watching this video. Today, I want to talk about the insurance costs for me when I was 18 years old and I first bought my 07 Mustang GT. I feel like a lot of you guys are in the same boat as me around my age, want to get a fast, nice car, but you're worried about insurance, don't know what you're gonna pay. Hey, I want to tell you guys exactly what you guys are gonna pay for insurance, or at least what I paid for insurance. So yeah, let's get into it. All right, so when I was 18 years old, I bought my 07 Mustang GT, paid for it myself, paid for the insurance myself. Everything is on me. My parents don't pay for a dime on that car. That is my car. Everything about my car, they've never put any money into it. I've done everything to it. So I'm sure a lot of you guys are wondering, what would insurance be on a car at 18 years old like this? Well, let me tell you. When I went to get my car, I had one accident on my record. I rear-ended someone. It wasn't a big deal, but it still goes on your record. It's still an accident, whatever. So, obviously, insurance like Allstate, Geico, State Farm, any of those big names was gonna be out of the question. It was gonna be absolutely ridiculous to insure this car being 18 years old through one of those companies. When I was buying the car, the dealership I bought the car at, they had an insurance company they worked with. It was like a smaller local insurance company that could give me a better rate than just about anywhere else could give me. Pulled this out on Geico, Allstate, State Farm, those places. It was like $400, $500, even $600 a month for that car for me. And I was like, absolutely not happening. Because I did not want to insure with one of the bigger companies, because honestly, I just straight up couldn't afford it. I went with a smaller insurance company that was local through the dealership, and they gave me a rate of $310.54 a month for full coverage insurance on my 07 Mustang GT. That came out to be over $3,700 a year just to insure this car, just to drive this car, just to have full coverage insurance on this car, $3,700 a year. And I'm sure a lot of you guys are watching this like, holy fuck, you were paying $310 a month to insure this car? And damn right I was. I wanted the car and I was like, fuck it, we're gonna pay $300 a month to insure this car because I want this car. And yeah, I'm sure there's people out there that pay like a fraction of that for insurance a month on even a similar car, if not like any other car. I'm sure it's way cheaper, but for me, it was $310 a month. Mind you, I did end up getting 2 speeding tickets. So yeah, insurance skyrocketed for me. Years later, I cleaned up my act, cleaned up my driving, got a little bit older. Now I'm 20, still have this car, and still insuring it under my name. Everything's mine. And I found a different insurance company that charges less than $310 a month, because I was like, okay, this is ridiculous. We gotta like tone this down a little bit. $310 a month is ridiculous. So I went, looked for cheaper insurance companies and ended up finding one that was cheaper than my previous insurance company. So now that I am with a different insurance company, they charge me $134.76 a month for full coverage on this car. Like, saving over $170 a month on insurance on this car just by switching companies again, cleaning up my driving record a little bit, and getting a little bit older. But $134 a month to insure that car, that comes out to be $1,617 a year, which honestly, I am very satisfied with. With my driving record, my age, and the car I own, I'm not gonna find insurance cheaper than that. I am just like, I'm very satisfied with that. But to get this car, man, $310 a month, like 30 something hundred dollars a year in insurance just to drive that car is ridiculous. I did it. I don't recommend it, but if you want the car, go ahead. So if you guys are looking to buy a muscle car, sports car, nice car, fast car, whatever you want to call it, at the age of 18, 20 years old, this is just a video to gauge you guys on what you're looking to spend on insurance. Obviously, some of you guys' driving records are gonna be different than mine. Some of you guys live in different states, so I'm sure that plays a factor. And some of you guys are probably gonna get different coverage, so that plays a factor too. But I wanna make this video give you guys a little like insight on my insurance costs and my 07 Mustang GT and like what I was paying. So you guys, if you're looking to get a car like this, you know what you're looking to pay, you know? Did I overpay for insurance on that car? Probably did. Most likely, yeah, overpaid for insurance. But was it worth it? 100%, we'd do it all over again, a million times over. I love the car. I don't regret it. I don't regret paying $310 a month to insure this car. Like, literally my insurance was more than my payments at one point. That's how bad that was. So that's gonna be it for today's vlog. I just wanted to do a short, quick little vlog today on 4th of July, let you guys know what I paid for insurance on this car. I thought it'd be an interesting video, especially for some of you younger guys like me looking to get into cars, and specifically fast cars, sports cars, muscle cars. Yeah, you know. This is gonna conclude today's vlog, you guys. If you guys found this video helpful or enjoyed the vlog, smash a thumbs up. Comment down below what car you own and what your insurance rate is. And also comment down below if you're looking to get a car like this, what car you're looking to get. And I might be able to help you out a little bit quoting it. I know I already said this, but I want to say one last time, thank you guys so much for 7,000 subscribers. That's amazing. You guys are amazing. Thank you for coming back, watching the video, subscribing, commenting, liking the videos, all that you guys do for the channel. I appreciate it, and that's what keeps me going. Road to 10K, baby. Let's go. 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I think we can do it. And obviously, if you guys have been watching for a while, or it's your first time here and you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you don't miss an upload. Before the July, guys, peace out. Oh, by the way, when we were filming, I checked, we jumped 2 more subscribers. Like, let's freaking go, you guys. You guys are the best, I swear. I've been going ape shit. I don't cut his honor, all the pussy looking basic. Dressing like Nirvana, run my veins without the laces. No, if I don't like you, I'll smell up in your face, bitch. I'm on the same shit.